Hi everyone. So I'll be talking more about why GraphQL over here. So before I start, a little about myself. Next slide. So my name is Anupam Dagar. I'm a GitHub campus expert from IIIT Allahabad in India. I have been a software developer at Hazura, a former contributor at Zulip, and currently contributing to FOSS Asia. Coming to my community, I'm a community leader of Geek Haven, and I have been the main core team member of organizing the Hackathon North Hackathon. Next slide, please. So why GraphQL over REST? Next slide. So the main part is like why people choose to GraphQL over REST is that it resolves two of the main issues which are found with the REST. And next slide, please. So I'll be just telling this about more by taking an example. Next slide. So yeah, the example comprises of a simple feed app. So a simple feed app may consist of many posts, and the posts may have many of the attributes like the title, author ID, view count, like count, and like dates, etc. Next slide. So here are two resources, the users and the posts. So users is like one database and the post another database, and both are linked together with a foreign key. Next slide. So here you can see a sample query in REST to fetch the post. So you do a one query to get the post, and you get the user ID inside that, and you want to show the user ID also, so you do another request to with the user ID to get the user's detail. Next slide. So suppose the project has been running for about 2 years now, and the design specifications has changed, and they say, okay, we don't want to show the view count in the post. So what would you do? So next slide. So the main component which comes here is like you will first of all think to discard the view count post directly, and other thing is like you will just like don't use the view count field which is getting from the response. So next slide. So yeah, so here are the two main issues with the REST. One is the like multiple round trips being used. In the first case, when you need to show the user count and the post count, so you did two requests to get the single resource completed. Other is like overfetching of data. In the second case, when you have to like discard the view count field from the response, so it's like overfetching of data. And next part is like documenting API becomes difficult because when you have a lot of endpoints being there. Next slide. So yeah, how GraphQL solves these issues? So GraphQL solves these issues by providing a single endpoint to all your data needs. So what you do is like you specify your DB name and the column which you want from the request, and it fetches the data from all over there. So yeah, you get and update only the data you need or delete anything you just require. So suppose I have to discard the view count, so in my get query, so I'll just remove that view count field and I won't get that attribute in my response. And finally, documenting the API is easy because you have a single endpoint, and so you just change over the which fields you need to get and you need to mutate. Next slide. So that's it. To get the more updates, like stay connected with me, you can follow me on GitHub, LinkedIn, or like Twitter. Next slide. Thank you very much.